Now that we've created a QuickBooks Online account, we're going to learn how to navigate around the account, and in this video we will also learn how to adjust the account settings. So here we are in the account that we just created in the previous video. And notice you come straight to the dashboard, which I mentioned is a general summary of your operations, and you can browse this later. But there are only three different areas that you will have to click in order to operate and manage your books and records and manage your QuickBooks Online account. Three simple areas. They're either the cog symbol here, or the plus sign here, or this list on the left. So let me explain what each of these are. First of all, what's this cog? Well, very simple. The cog symbol is for basically the setup and maintenance of your QuickBooks Online account. If you look at the choices, you can see that these are things you only do once in a while. And once you do them, your QuickBooks Online account will behave differently or have different things available once you set this up. So then what's this plus sign here? Well, let's talk about that. If you look at the plus sign, you'll see that the choices that it's offering are things that you would do on a day-to-day basis. These are most of the transactions that you'll do and some of the other day-to-day tasks, and that's how you can think of it. Now, the third area is very simple. It's this list on the left. And mind you, once you click on any of these, a lot of these choices are simply a repeat of a lot of the choices that you can get from the plus sign and from the cog. However, there are some things, very few, but there are some things that you have to go to the dashboard to this list on the left to be able to do. For example, if you want to do bank feeds, the only way to get into bank feeds is to click banking in the list on the left. If you want to look at or manage your reports, the only way to do that is to look at this list on the left. But most of the other choices that come up when you click here on the left are choices that are repeated from the plus sign or the cog icon. Now let's adjust the settings. When I say settings, I mean defaults. This means the options or the automatic behavior of the file or the online account. In the desktop version, this is called the preferences. For example, let's track expenses by customer or job. Now, when you first create the company, it is not set up to track the expenses by customer or by job. And I'm going to prove that to you before we change the settings. If I click expenses and I tell QuickBooks I want to enter an expense and I click add an expense, okay, you will notice right now that there is no field to put for which particular customer or which particular job this expense is for. I can put the name of the vendor I'm paying, I can put how I'm paying, I could put which expense account it goes to, I can describe it, I can even put a money amount. But right now, when you look over here, there is no field, there is no place to put which customer job the expense is for. So, we'll leave without saving, yes. Now, what you need to do is click the cog and then click account and settings. That's where you go to change the preferences and the defaults. Now, there are different categories. If you click company up here, you can change the information that appears on your reports and documents when you print for your own company name and address. This would be the place to put in the details of your own company. And of course, there are other categories of defaults, but let's click expenses. Notice automatically, track expenses by items and by customer is switched off. That was the reason there was no field to enter for customer or job when you record an expense. But watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to click on. Okay, there we go. Track expenses by customer. an item. Now when I click save, I have changed the settings. This one is on. Now I'm going to click the X in the top right. You might not be able to, if I do this, you could see there's an X in the top right to close out the window. Now when I come back to expenses and I click add an expense, notice the change. Notice there's an additional field here called customer. I now have the ability to add a customer to a transaction where I record an expense, so I know which customer the expense is for. And that's an example of changing one of the settings.